Hi, I'm Jürgen, and this is my game Miravora. It's the free demo version, and today I'm going to play it on the hardest difficulty. So let's go! A million years in the future, science and technology have reached unimaginable levels. At its peak, mankind has adjusted climate, oceans, entire land masses to fit its needs. However, evolutionary pressure has turned spiders into a far superior species that eventually outpaced human civilization. Humans are now close to extinction. People live in small tribes scattered across the world, relying on remains of powerful technology they didn't invent and barely understand. So this is a randomly generated character. You can change stuff if you want to. Or just go ahead and type in a name. Yesterday, a huge swarm attacked my home, Camp Concordia. Everybody fit for combat activated their defense implants. Everybody else fled into stasis. The fight went well at first, but suddenly the generators failed. Lacking weapon systems, the fighters were torn apart within seconds. Then all stasis fields collapsed but for mine. I am the only survivor. My throat hurts from crying and screaming. But despair, sorrow, or wrath won't get me anywhere. I need to set forth and seek for other camps, other people, for a new home. Okay, that's our job, I guess. So let's start the journey. We can choose our difficulty and of course I count as an expert, I guess. So this is the world map. There are only two camps and this is the one we're coming from, so there's nothing to do here. So let's go there. The transportation network was easier to figure out than I expected. A drone arrived after a few minutes. I got teleported into its small but cozy cabin. I'm leaving Concordia for the first time in my life. The onboard computer urgently warns that Transquilitatis is infested and uninhabited. There is no information on the status of the camp's defense facilities and my combat training is incomplete. I'm really worried, but I have no choice. Well, I guess my combat training is not incomplete, I hope at least. So what do we have here? That's a relatively weak wave. Yeah, pretty much all waves are relatively weak. That can happen even on expert. It's randomly generated, but let's see. I mean, okay, it's weak, so I think I don't really need any combat skills. I can focus on perks mostly, and this perk gives a small but permanent score bonus, so that's nice. And this perk gives a temporary bonus, but a large one. Yeah, 250% score, that's nice. Because the score determines the rewards I get after the battle, so that's very good. I could also heal my character, but I'm of course at full health, so that's not useful. Let's start. These are all assault spiders, you can tell by the red names. Assault spiders always attack. They don't do anything else. And it can make them dangerous, but since this is a weak wave, they should be fine. In fact, I think I can annoy them a little bit. Come on, spiders. So this is the turret. Okay, maybe I annoyed them a little bit too much. No, I got poisoned. There's intoxication building up. And when it reaches me, it's really hard to move. And that's it. Like now. That's not good. Oh, this is bad. Oh no, what have I done? Oh, okay. I think I got a little bit lucky. Wave's almost done. There's only one attacker remaining. Oof. Well. Maybe I'm lacking combat training. Okay. But I have a nice score, that's fine. And this wave is even easier than the previous one. So I can heal a little bit. And that should be enough. Let's go for more score. More score is always nice. Yes. So this is a turret with an entry trigger. And that means as long as I stay within its range, it starts or it keeps shooting at enemies. So that's useful. I have to watch out because there are two groups now. So an important mechanic in this game is that you shoot faster when you're close to enemies. So I actually want to be close to enemies, but not too close. Because, well, you saw what happens. They are dangerous, indeed. But it's another mechanic in this game is that you avoid all damage by being airborne. So jumping, dashing and gliding is the way to go. Another weak wave, like all of them pretty much. I'm a bit disappointed. But I can have fun anyway. Just annoy the heck out of them. Come on. Ooh, I didn't pay attention. Okay, this wave is has a low score, but also very few enemies, and so they are all relatively high level. I think I should have paid a little bit more attention and maybe invest in some defensive skills, but seems to work anyway. So this is gliding by keeping space pressed. It's very useful, but you can't stay airborne forever. So eventually you have to pick a landing spot. And that is a very important skill to learn in this game. So that went very well. Another weak wave, and this time I get 5 health restored as a reward. That's very nice. I can use that. Okay, we have an elite group, in this case protectors. I think I should invest a little bit in combat skills. Oh, I have ice, that's nice against protectors. I think that should be enough because the score is really not all that high. So yeah, power. Power, this is a permanent power bonus, and what power does is it increases my rate of fire and the rate of fire of turrets and skills. So this is really, as a, I mean, you want to reach a very high power if you can. That is a very, really good perk. So one of the nice things of ice is that not only freezes its enemies, but it also makes them more vulnerable to fire, and that is a really nice combo. So I like to have ice. It's my favorite skill in this game. But all skills are super useful, and I think I am sometimes overusing ice. Oh, okay. Hi, they are all coming. It's getting a little bit tense here. But that's the way I like it. All those rage balls. Enraged spiders shoot occasionally rage balls. But they can also be dodged by jumping and gliding and dashing. Okay. Ah, that was that. I think I've got a little bit more health now than I started with, so it's nice. It happened because of the reward, of course. Okay, another wave. Oh, I see. We have some slime here. Slime is very slippery. And that's a problem because you can't jump when you're sliding. So that's something really important to watch out for. But again, all waves are so low level. I don't think I really need to worry about that. Maybe a little bit more healing. Yeah, that should be fine. Come on, no spiders. Come at me! That's the second group. Oops. Not making a lot of damage. But a lot of attacks. A lot of hits. And the electro attack is actually quite nasty. Because that makes a lot of damage. Bad timing. They are so low level, I have to keep them interested in me. That's the last one. Oh, there. The mini-map is quite useful to find the last remaining enemies. Okay, so this is the last wave already, and this one has a slightly higher score than the other ones. Do I want to care about that? Well, I lost already a lot of health, so maybe I should be a bit more wise about that. Yeah. Nano cure. Heals slowly but surely, so all these little rage balls would no longer be a problem, or should no longer be a problem. So nice thing about trees is that they are an obstacle to spiders, so slows them down a little bit. But they are not an obstacle to me. I can actually run through the trees like this. Very useful. Thank you. Oh, I got a little bit lucky there. Maybe this wave is stronger than I anticipated. But it's going well, actually. Ah, there. Manicure. Manicure also reduces intoxication a little bit, at least. So that's nice now. But it takes still some time. No, 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 no! Come on! Go away! I don't like you! Oh, no! No! Oh, last enemy already. Great! I did it! Did I lose any health? Manicure is still healing. Slowly. And now the wave should be finished. Nice. Camp reboots. I did it! Tranquilitatis is secure again. Everything seems to work properly. The military systems automatically deactivated when the battle ended, granting access to the housing units. The last entry in the log files is 80,000 years old. I left a note about my arrival. Okay. Character is a little bit exhausted from the battle, but that's just cosmetic. I lost more health than I planned to. But I get a health bonus. Nice. Okay. That's a huge health bonus. That's a random perk. And it could be something completely different. But that was perfect. Actually way more health than I needed. So that's perfect. So what do I get for my efforts? A few crafting ingredients. Like upgrade devices and a lot of clothing. And that is super important because clothing not just lets you customize your character, but it also provides super skills. And super skills work like normal skills, but they are a lot stronger. So that is something really nice to have. And also, when you die, you get to keep all your clothing. So that's a kind of meta progression in this game. Okay, this is an empty piece with empty slots. I could install an upgrade device in it, but all these items are so low level that it would be a waste. Actually, so I'm just going to keep them for a while. This is a doublet, but well, it has a power boost. So the overall level of that item is lower, but I like that. I actually like that skill. I want that. And what's that? Okay, I'll keep the other one. Item. Good, very nice. I guess that was the first battle. Thanks for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!